I got the call. I just got the call today that our vehicle, our new Raptor R, is in a production. I can't believe it. It's in production. Our Raptor R. I don't know of anyone else getting Raptor R this early. I think we're one of the very first people to get a brand new Ford Raptor R with over 700, well, no, exactly 700 horsepower, and it's gonna embark us on a whole new chapter on this channel of amazing off-road content and new ways of taking the race car, the track cars, to the racetrack. So let me touch base on that right now and give you the full rundown of getting a Raptor R this soon. This is the ultimate Ford truck ever made, the ultimate Raptor. We have the same engine as the GT500, which, hey, I used to have a GT500, didn't I, back in the day, a few years back. Love the car. It's actually so hilarious being back in a Mustang again. It's been a while. And the EcoBoost, hey, you know what? It sounds pretty good. That's full throttle. This is the email I got from Ford stating the rundown of what's going on with our new Raptor R. That means that, hey, it's happening. We got the car. The order's in, locked in. The vehicle is being created. I have my own VIN number. That's wild. I'm not going to share that yet. I have a VIN number, which is really, really funny to think about because, hey, it's moving fast. We just took delivery of, like, the first customer delivery Z06 on the market, and now we're getting a Raptor R this early? How is it happening? Major shout out to Middleton Ford. Those guys are the best around. They are totally into the off-road scene with tons of Broncos. They jump them, they do crazy stunts all the time. And the owners of the dealer are heavily into the racetrack. So they go to the track and we actually join them at Road America to drive their GT500 track pack around that legendary track. My first ever time going out there, and I cannot describe to you how amazing it was to drive up to 170 miles an hour. Obviously, Chuck, the owner of the car and dealer owner, was much faster when he drove it. It gave me a thrill ride around. I had a ton of fun. I really did. And I want to go back to that track with the Z06 and the McLaren. That's going to be a great idea. One issue we do have is that since we're using the new Z06 and the McLaren at the track a lot, we're going to need to find a good trailer. And to get a good trailer, I want to find something that's lightweight. So please let me know your recommendations below. The ball is moving. The ball is moving fast. And we got to start finishing off the entire lineup so that we can go to crazy tracks across the country way more often. I really love going to Laguna Seca, and that's my favorite track alongside Coda. The McLaren does so good there. I love that car. And the Z06 is an interesting car to put alongside it because I keep getting comments and questions asking me, hey Austin, which one would you rather drive or take home? I can't quite answer it because they're not similar. They're really not. And it's hard to touch base on. Stay tuned for our official head-to-head video. Oh yeah, and that reminds me, we actually saw the new Raptor R at the LA Auto Show.
And finally, right in front of me here, we have the Ford Raptor R. This is it. This is gonna be the race car hauler for the Z06 and the McLaren 600LT. We're really bad in gas mileage, I think, but I'm so happy it's finally getting built. So I'll let you guys know the exact build day when it rolls off the assembly line. Oh, that's right. The name of the orange was Code Orange, and it matches the orange for the Raptor R logos. All of the main highlight points for the Raptor R are going to be orange. That's why I end up going for orange as the main color. It might accent pretty well, or might just blend all in. I don't know. But 700 horsepower with the same engine we used to own in our GT500 is blowing my mind. And then here we have the all-new Ford Mustang Dark Horse. What are your thoughts? Should we continue down the path of ordering one and building it out for the racetrack with a manual transmission? It would be wild. We still have our name down with the dealership Middleton Ford to get one. So it's still on the table for sure. Just we haven't heard anything about true pricing yet, I don't think, and then when the vehicle will be available. Unique seeing the new angles on the taillights. But the exhaust diffuser, it's massive, isn't it? I would love to see like cool carbon fiber upgrades with it to make it not plastic, but I understand for the market segment. It gets me curious what the price point will be for this vehicle. Coming down, we have Trofeo RS tires, which are interesting. I've never seen an RS Trofeo. I know with my 600LT McLaren, they come with Trofeo Rs, same with the 765LT. So maybe the RS is even a stickier compound, or I'm not sure. Let me know in the comments below. Cool blue brakes to match the all-new paint job that changes colors all throughout the body. For a contact patch, you do have 305s up front and the 315s out back on 19-inch wheels. So I think the setup for the track will be very good. I don't know how it will compare against our old GT350R because this is naturally aspirated, same as our R. It's got less power, definitely it does. Interestingly, coming to the bottom left, this air intake is actually closed up. I wonder why, because the other intakes are very functional. Let me know why the bottom left air intake vent is shut. Really interesting seeing this thing finally in person. I saw them drive around in Michigan, prototypes, but seeing the finished version, I would say it's similar, right? With the hips right here in the sides, but very different.
Anyways, shout out to the Mustang community. These cars are so much fun. I cannot wait to get the proper setup for trailering the Z06 and the McLaren to the racetrack. We also have a new delivery next week. I'm not announcing that quite yet. Stay tuned, it's wild. It's got a lot of power, more than the Raptor, and we'll be getting the keys to it next week. So I cannot wait. Please let me know your guesses down below, and we're off to doing more racetrack videos with the Z06 and more. You're gonna enjoy it a lot. It's what we're good at, right? And our first official test run went well. I had fun. Now I'm getting into the groove and I'm ready to push this car hard. What should we do with the new Raptor R? Any ideas? Any ideas? Please run them by me right now. Should we modify it? Throw more horsepower on it? I'm very hesitant on modding the Z06 and the McLaren because these cars are being pushed 10 tenths for lap after lap on the track. If anything happens, I don't want to have that that scare. With the off-road truck, hey, the repercussions I don't think are near as bad if something goes wrong. It's not the same. What do you think? Should we try to get more horsepower out of the Raptor R, or take it to some sick areas for nice jumps or sand duning? That'll be fun. There's so many good sand dunes around us down here. Okay, we got to get the Glamis, actually. Glamis sand dunes is the best. I know you guys love trucks, so please let me know any ideas you do have to do with the new Raptor R. We're gonna make sure to do it. It's gonna be a lot of fun. The content's not ending. We're delivering the ultimate content for all of you guys. Anyways, thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, make sure to hit that like button to help me out, and subscribe for much more great content coming out your way. Hit the like button, subscribe, and I'll see all of you in the next episode.